on Thursday, hold on to hope. We're going to be talking about the hope that his radio gives you. You know, even before I was here, I listened to his radio, of course, was part of the family because it gave me daily encouragement. You know, no matter what I was going through, if I was having a good day, bad day, you know, whatever was happening, I knew that the songs and what everybody was talking about would make my heart lighter, make me feel closer to God and really encourage my walk with God. And so that's the hope that I held on to and always hold on to.
I don't know about you, but when I listen, I hear the songs a little differently through COVID-19.
Oh, yeah.
You seem to have, at least I do, I seem to have just a little bit more hope, just listening, knowing, okay, it's going to be okay when the stress factor is like off the charts when you're going through this junk. You know it's going to be all right.
Yeah, you just hold on to, like you say, the song lyrics. What may have meant one thing in January, today, what is it, April 27th, means something totally different. And you're seeing things in a whole new perspective, and you really see how God is carrying you through as long as you have that hope. But think about people that don't have their hope in Jesus Christ. What are they holding on to right now? And so that's what we're trying to do, is reach more and more people.
So here's the thing. His radio is listener supported. Yeah. Last week, we were going to have our fund drive. We call it Friendraiser, where we raise the operational budget for the station. That's put on hold. That's postponed until sometime this summer. We're still trying to see when is the best time for that. However, this Thursday, we do need a little bit of help because we're falling behind for obvious reasons. It's COVID-19. I mean, it's going on. So here's the thing. If you can't give, that's okay. But there's others, and maybe that's you, that can give a gift that's going on Thursday. It'll exclusively be online at hisradio.com. And hey, you don't have to wait. You can do that right now. Hisradio.com to give your
gift. His morning crew.
Christina and Brian, quite the couple. They just survived, and they live in New York City, coronavirus.
Oh, good.
They got over it. They're out of the hospital. It was a tough go, especially for her. She was in twice because of Corona-19. Yeah. Now, they were married like over 20 years ago.
Okay.
They had an apartment just outside the World Trade Centers. Oh. They were looking out their window of the apartment when they saw the second tower plane, the plane go into the second tower.
Yeah.
And then when that thing came down, it ruined their apartment. Oh. And they had to boogie out of that thing. I mean, quickly. They survived 9/11 and the coronavirus.
Wow.
Christina and Brian.
How did they keep their positivity up?
I know, right? It's like, wow, should we just move out of New York?
For real.
Because this has happened twice because of the epicenter of the pandemic, but they're making it.
Yeah. And that's a story that's coming out of 9/11 that I wouldn't have even thought about, honestly, is how many people were affected that weren't even right there in that epicenter. I mean, they were a little ways away from where it really happened.
You're talking about 9/11?
Yeah.
When the towers came down?
Yeah.
I mean, they were in the plume of smoke that came down. Then they were running for their lives and all this stuff. So they survived two horrific things in New York City. The coronavirus just recently and then 9/11 because they were just freshly married at that point.
Wow.
Living in New York. I'm telling you,
right? His morning crew.
I want to say welcome if you are new to the family of His Radio, like Della, who is listening online in Wisconsin.
Wyoming.
Oh, Wyoming.
Yes.
Woo, that's cool. Wyoming. So Della's listening in Wyoming. Mm-hmm. She already said, I need prayer for something, and we prayed for her. She said, I heard that you're doing this one-day fundraiser on Thursday. Can I give a gift? And she gave.
That is amazing.
Thank you for doing that, Della. I'm Rob. That's Liz. It's His Morning Crew on His Radio.
And we are holding on to hope. Of course, our hope is in Jesus Christ, in our relationship with God. But we hope that His Radio has brought you hope in your life. One lady shared her story with us, and she said her walk with Jesus has taken her many places. His Radio has been theme music through it all. She's ugly cried with us. I totally get that. But she's also laughed until she cried with us. But through it all, we've given her that hope. And she said she hates that as a family, they waited so long to help financially. But now they are. And thank you for devoting life to doing His work with His Radio.
Listen, we understand this is COVID-19. And there's a lot of people that are in need. And if you cannot give to His Radio, we totally get it. We understand that. But if you have to be one of those that can, would you give a gift of support? Hold On to Hope comes up on Thursday. It's a one-day fundraiser. You help provide hope with your gift online at hisradio.com. Hey, you know what? You don't have to wait. Just like Della, She gave online this morning from Wyoming. Hello. And you're here. So go ahead and do that online. If you can't, we understand. But if you can, that's hisradio.com, hisradio.com. And hold on to hope. Our one-day giving event online at hisradio.com is coming up this Thursday.
His Morning Crew.
I do have a question for Liz.
I'm not even going to talk to you right now.
No. She doesn't even know what I'm going to say just yet. Okay. I guess she knows the tone of my voice. Uh-huh. So here's the thing. I saw on her Instagram a brand new dog that was in the house. I'm like, is this a new dog? But no, as I inspected closer, this is actually her dog, Charlie, that should be poofing in all of this. It's a golden doodle?
A golden doodle.
Doodle, okay.
Yeah.
Doodle. A golden doodle. Which is like, you know, you got all this puffy, furry.
Right. She's normally just like a mop, like a rag mop or mm-hmm. something. But
so what happened? Because the dog is like, has no fur. What did you do? It looks like a different breed.
Well, you know, I had tried to cut her hair, gosh, what, a month ago or something?
You butchered it, the COVID-19 thing. Yeah.
She couldn't see, and we couldn't get any appointments, you know, at the groomer because they were shut down for a while, furloughed or whatever. And so finally, I saw they had an opening. They had come back to work. And so I got her an appointment. And because she's so curly and we tried to brush her through the whole COVID, you know, distancing thing, mm-hmm. She had gotten a little matted. And they ended up doing a nose to toes is what they call it, shaving her down. She has literally no hair.
That's the fix, was to just shave it all off.
That's all they could do. And they were like, I'm so sorry. I, like, even her whiskers, and I tried, every time I tried to brush her underbelly, uh-huh. like, she would look at me like, I want to bite you. I'm not going to.
Right.
But I'm giving you notice right now. You need to stop. Mm. And so she looks like the cat from the Friends episode where Rachel had it on a pillow. Uh-huh. It's like an Asian cat or something. I don't even know. Poor Charlie.
Wow. What's she going to do?
She's freezing. Like, she was shivering, so I bought her a t-shirt.
How'd that go?
Well, she stopped playing. She shut down.
Yeah.
She was playing with a ball. I put the t-shirt on, and she literally dropped the ball out of her mouth and stood there and looked at me like, I'm not doing it.
Tail between legs.
Oh, yes.
Yeah. Just, very anxious with the t-shirt on.
Yeah.
It's like, what did you do?
She's still cute as a button.
Well, she looks like a brand new dog.
A whole new breed.
A whole new breed. So that's what those labradoodles look like.
His Morning Crew.
We want to thank you for praying for His Radio during this time. As we pray with you, I mean, with God, we're stronger together, right? And you're not alone. We can hold on to hope. And here's the thing. His Radio is holding on to hope right along with you because this is a listener-supported radio station. Last week was going to be our fundraiser.
Yes.
Where we're going to raise the operational budget for this listener-supported radio station. You know what? We're like, we got to focus on you, not focus on, and we do need to have need. We have needs here.
We have needs, yeah.
They're very, very real, but we've got to postpone that until coming up this summer sometime. We'll figure that part out. But coming up on Thursday, you can help provide hope with your gift to His Radio online at hisradio.com. As a matter of fact, we heard from somebody who is giving a $30 a month gift. So they did that online. Okay. But they said, you know what? This is so difficult for us right now. We're holding on to hope because of His Radio. I feel like I'm not accomplishing anything because I lost my job before COVID-19. Oh, okay. And now it's here and I can't find work mm-hmm. anywhere. But yet they're holding on to hope and they're giving a gift.
Wow.
Which is incredible when you think about it.
They're stepping out in faith, mm-hmm. which I love. You know that God is going to sustain you through all of this. Got to hold on to it.
Now, we understand. If you can't give a gift, yeah. we get it because we're walking through this COVID-19 thing together. But if you can, you can do one of two things. Either go online on Thursday mm-hmm. and give your gift of support during our Hold On to Hope Day, or you can do it now.
Right
you don't
now?
Even have to wait. At hisradio.com. That is hisradio.com. As together
Robin
we hold
Liz.
On.
Liz, His Morning Crew.
I love Tom Hanks. Don't you?
He's a good guy, it seems like. Yeah. At least the movies he's in is amazing.
Right.
And you hear him do good from time to time.
Yeah, well, he's doing good. There is a little boy. Of course, Tom Hanks and his wife, Rita Wilson, had coronavirus.
They did, didn't they?
Yeah, they had been traveling in Australia, had the symptoms, went to the hospital there a couple of weeks, still recovering. And so while he was there, there was a little boy named Corona DeVries, who's 8 years old. He sent a letter to Tom and said, first off, he said, how are you? How are you and your wife doing? because he knew that they had the coronavirus.
Oh, he cared.
Yeah. But later in the letter, he said, I've been bullied at school because my name is Corona. And of course, kids have been acting like, you know, he was a virus and things like that. It was just terrible. And so, of course, Tom, it hit his heart. And he sent little Corona a letter back. And he said, your letter made my wife and I feel so wonderful. Thank you for being such a good friend. Friends make their friends feel good when they're down. Okay. Didn't just send a letter, but also, do you know Tom Hanks collects vintage typewriters?
Oh, I didn't know that.
Yeah. Well, he sent a Corona typewriter to little Corona, who's 8 years old, and as a gift. And it's a nice typewriter.
Yeah, if kids know what that is
right,
anymore.
Exactly.
That is vintage, but it actually the brand is called Corona.
Yes.
So he sent a Corona typewriter to Corona.
Yes.
Who this kid was being bullied because his name is Corona, the virus kind of thing.
And even told him, he said, you know, your name means ring around the sun, a crown.
Really?
So gave this little kid, like I have goosebumps because of this, because he gave the little kid such encouragement and just took the time to be special.
Robin Liz.
His morning crew.
Miss England, and I'm going to try her name.
Oh, okay. Hold on. Let's see. Let's see what happens here.
Basha Mukherjee.
I'll give it to her. There you go.
Okay.
Give it to her.
She is the reigning Miss England. And of course, she was crowned earlier this year. And usually, pageant winners, queens get to go on kind of like a tour. And it's an ambassador tour. It's usually a humanitarian tour. But because of COVID-19 and social distancing, she didn't get to do that. So what's she doing? She is not sitting at home in her sweatpants. She is a junior doctor.
Okay.
She has two medical degrees, and she decided, I'm not going to sit at home. I'm not going to, you know, do this whole thing. So she went back to work, and she's helping patients with COVID-19 who are trying to get trying to get over COVID-19. And she's also appearing in some public service announcements, trying to encourage people in the area, just stay home.
Look at her go.
I know.
Miss England, huh?
Miss England.
Try her. You got to see this name.
Okay.
Try her name again.
Basha Mukherjee.
Say it fast.
Okay. Really? You say it fast.
No.
Basha Mukherjee. Basha Mukherjee.
Okay.
Rob and
good
Liz.
Effort.
His morning crew.
One of the people, or I should say industries that are really hitting it hard, getting a hard hit through COVID-19 are the farmers.
Oh.
You know, there's a lot of produce that's available when you go to the grocery store,
sure.
But there's a lot of small businesses that are closed up
right.
That usually supplies that kind of stuff. Mm-hmm. I was just reading in Florida alone, crop losses just through mid-April is over $522
million.
Millions. That's just Florida. So Publix, the grocery store chain, mm-hmm. I don't know if you know this, their world headquarters. Hello. Their headquarters are in Florida.
Mm-hmm.
So they thought, you know what, we're seeing this in Florida. We know it's in other places where we are. So we want to do something to help. So they've started a program. They're buying, at least in the first week of this program, 150,000 pounds of produce and over 43,000 gallons of milk. And they're going to give that to the needy.
Oh, I was wondering, what are they going to do with it? They're not just buying it so it goes bad, obviously.
Right, yeah.
Giving it to the needy.
Yeah.
So helping two different sects of, you know, the community.
The
wow,
farmers
yeah.
That they need to buy it from because, boy, they're losing a lot of crop. And that means that's a lot of their finances, you know, their livelihood. And the needy who need to eat.
Yeah.
So they're helping out in a big way.
And I bet the soup kitchens and the homeless shelters are like, milk? You're giving us milk? I mean, that's huge.
Yeah.
That's awesome.
That is huge. And Publix just started.
His morning crew.
There's a couple of outreaches in the Grand Strand, the Myrtle Beach area, mm-hmm. where you can hear his radio on 88.3 called Help for Kids and Backpack Buddies. So these specifically target kids. Well, here we are with COVID-19. Not a lot is coming in. And so Sherry Mountain is the executive assistant of the Grand Strand Health. And she thought, you know what I want to do? I want to help out. So she, at the hospital, where they're already on the front lines, where they're already doing stuff for people with COVID-19, decided to organize a clothing drive, a food drive, and get supplies so that she can get them to Help for Kids and Backpack Buddies, filling up this large truck filled with canned goods and clothing and baby care supplies to pay it forward to people in the community.
That is amazing that people take that one little idea and just run with it. Because sometimes I think a lot of people, myself included, will get an idea and go, oh, well, somebody's probably already doing something like that. Nope, she filled a need. She saw it and she filled it.
So some businesses have decided, we want to help out too. So they're doing it.
Cool.
Filling that truck, getting it to these two organizations so the kids can get some help during this whole thing of social distancing now.
Right, because the kids that are normally on free and reduced lunch, that get breakfast, they get lunch, they're not at school right now. And a lot of schools are, you know, stepping up and they're bringing the food to the kids, but not necessarily on weekend.
Plus the school supplies.
Yeah.
I mean, Backpack Buddies are now helping out because, okay, they're not in school. Right. They're not getting the pencils and the pens and the crayons and all that other stuff.
Yeah.
Now they are in the Grand Strand because of these folks.
Get some Cheerios in there.
Hey, that's not a bad idea.
I know it.
Might as well. You can do stuff with Cheerios outside of just eating them.
Mornings with Rob and Liz.
You know, his radio is there in the good times. We can laugh together. We can have positivity and great stories. But also when you're going through something that is a little difficult. And so we had someone that said they are regular listeners and they have been for a lot of years. And they've also been giving for many, many years. But they went through something pretty rough over the last year or so. And in fact, they've been going through something rough for a while. Their daughter, she was 21 years old. She had her second heart transplant. And unfortunately, she started a decline, complications, and it led to her passing just this past September. But she said his radio and his love got them through that time, through the stories, through the songs, through their entire journey. And they just can't thank his radio enough. So they were holding on to hope and still are today.
They certainly are. And here's the thing. You can help provide hope for those with a gift online at hisradio.com. See, we postponed last week's fundraiser for obvious reasons. I mean, it's COVID-19. Sure. We've got to focus on hope and giving hope to so many people. And yet we're a listener-supported radio station here is radio. And so we're hopeful that on Thursday, people like you will join the team. Now, listen, we understand that not everybody can do that.
Right.
Maybe you can't do that right now because of the uncertainty of these times and what you fell into. But there are those who can give and help provide hope. So if you can on Thursday, join us online at hisradio.com with your gift of support.
Yeah. And if you can't, why not pray with us? Pray for us that we get through this, you know, all together, because that's what we're going to do. But we would love for you to do that as well.
Thank you for providing hope. And if you can give that gift online, you don't even have to wait until Thursday. You can do that right now. Others have done that, as a matter of fact, this morning. Hisradio.com. That is hisradio.com as we hold
Rob
on to
and
hope
Liz.
Together.
His Morning Crew.
There's a great new app I want to tell you about. It's Purposity. And so what they do is they take purpose and generosity. Two guys out of Atlanta, they have come up with this app. And what you can do is you go on, you know, you create your account, and then you search your community and see where the needs are. And these are needs that you could do just honestly through Amazon or a local business or whatever. Or you could go out and, you know, put boots on the ground and help somebody in need. But also, if you are somebody that needs help, you can post on Purposity on this app and get the help that you're looking for.
Oh, that's great.
I know.
I want to post this on our Care Community Facebook page so some people can get a hold of this to help each other out.
Yeah. They say, we know that you can't buy your way to happiness, but you can give to others and you can live life to the fullest and help, you know, maybe get a little joy in your life.
The way that people are helping to provide hope like that is absolutely amazing.
Yeah. And think about it before COVID-19. I'm not saying I wish, you know, I'm glad that we've gone through all of this, not at all, but we can take the positive from it because it's given us maybe some extra time where we can give back. We have the time. Maybe we had the cash before, now we have the time to help.
I have a feeling after all this is said and done is behind us a little bit, that we're going to act a little differently toward each other.
I hope so.
To help out like that.
And I hope it's long lasting. It's not short lived, you know, 6 months, we kind of get back in that normal routine.
Sadly, it might.
It might.
But if enough people purpose not to and keep it going,
Rob,
you just never know what could happen.
His Morning Crew.
You can help provide hope and let people know that they can hold on to hope today.
Della was listening early this morning. One of the first texts that we got, and she was talking about she needed prayer. There's a situation going on in her family. But as we were talking back and forth, she said, I just stumbled on your radio station. It was crazy. And she said, thank you for the encouragement because I needed that. And may God continue to bless his ministry. And then she said, how can I give a gift so that you can give encouragement and hope to others?
Isn't that something? Oh, here's the thing about Della. She lives. Are you ready for this? Because we asked, what's this area code?
Yeah.
She said, I live in Wyoming.
And just stumbled upon his radio. It was there when she needed it.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's a God thing right there.
And that was this morning. Can you imagine over 35 years of ministry of his radio and how that hope has been provided for people? And here's the thing. It's even more so now because of the uncertainty that we're living in through COVID-19 and social distancing. You've been living there yourself. So here's the thing. Last week, this listener-supported radio station, in case you didn't know, we're listener-supported. That's why Della wanted to give a gift. Mm-hmm. She wanted to help. We were going to have a fund drive. We call it Friendraiser. We postponed it for obvious reasons. Hope needs to be broadcast on his radio. But we still need a little bit of help.
Right.
And so on Thursday, this week, just one day, we're going to ask for people who can give. Not everybody can. Maybe you're in that part yourself, or maybe you can give. We're going to ask Thursday for people to give online. But here's the thing. People have already been jump-starting today, which is so cool to see.
Yeah, just like Della, you don't have to wait until Thursday. If you're like, I can do that right now, you can do it on the His Radio app or at hisradio.com.